Good afternoon, everyone.
Good afternoon, sir.
Yes, mark this case study 3 as one of the most important case studies. Diya Patel, kindly read the question.
Mr. Prem commenced business of trading in electronic goods with an initial capital of rupees 15 lakh. Out of the said rupees 15 lakh, he paid rupees 10 lakh towards purchase of electronic goods. He further spent rupees 2 lakh on furnishing the shop and 35,000 for purchase of computer and printer. Rupees 10,000 is yet to be paid to supplier of computer. He sold goods costing rupees 5 lakh for rupees 7 lakh in cash and goods costing rupees 2,50,000 for rupees 3,10,000 on credit. Goods sold on credit for rupees 25,000 were returned being defective. These goods costing rupees 20,000 were returned to the supplier. Looking into the response, he decided to trade in home appliances also and further invested rupees 5 lakh. He purchased electronic goods and home appliances for rupees 8 lakh, out of which purchases of rupees 2 lakh were on credit. Due to an earthquake, two LCD televisions costing rupees 50,000 were completely destroyed. Mr. Prem received an insurance claim of rupees 30,000. A customer purchased goods costing rupees 2,25,000 for rupees 3 lakh and was allowed discount of rupees 15,000.
Which discount is this, everyone? Yesterday we studied which types of discounts?
Trade discount and cash discount.
Yes, Om and Vyom, very good. Trade discount and cash discount. So which discount is this 15,000? What do you think?
Sir, cash discount.
Sir, trade discount.
Okay. Om?
Yes, sir.
What is a cash discount?
That means if we buy in bulk, they will give us a discount.
Bulk discount is trade discount.
Oh, sorry.
Right. Cash discount is when you pay cash, when you pay the money instantly.
Yeah.
So this one is which discount? Okay. Trade discount.
Trade discount.
Because you are getting this discount for buying goods of 3 lakh rupees at a time. Are you purchasing goods of big amount or not?
Yes, sir.
And there where you get the discount, it is called a trade discount. It is a trade discount because you are buying goods worth rupees 3 lakhs, big amount. And therefore our business is giving our customers a discount of 15,000 for purchasing goods of so big amount. So that is a trade discount. Yes, read it further, Diya.
He was further allowed discount of rupees 5,000 for payment within agreed time.
What is this discount? What is this? Cash or
cash?
Cash.
This is cash discount. As I told you, cash discount is when you pay the money instantly or within stipulated time. So he has paid the money within that stipulated agreed time. He further gets discount of 5,000 when he pays the money. That is cash discount. Yes, Diya, further.
He paid salary to Shyam of rupees 55,000. Rupees 5,000 were yet to be paid. He insured the goods and paid insurance premium of rupees 10,000. Out of this, rupees 5,000 are for the next year. Mr. Prem withdraw.
How can you pay insurance premium for next year? How can you pay insurance premium for next year? First of all, just understand one more thing. In accountancy, there are two types of years. One is calendar year. The other is called accounting year or financial year. One is calendar year, the other is called accounting year or which year? What is the calendar year from January to December? But accounting year is from April to March. Okay, therefore you'll see that chartered accountants are busiest in the month of March. Why all the chartered accountants are busiest in the month of March? Because for accounting, the year ending is on 31st March. So they have to close all the books of accounts in the month of March. That's why they are busiest people in the month of March. Income tax also follows the financial year only. Income tax, you always pay for the income which you earn not in January to December, but in April to March. So henceforth, whenever we commerce people talk about years, then for us, year will not be the one which starts in January. For all of us, year will be the one which starts on 1st of
April.
Okay. And mind you all, I am not making an April fool of you. I am serious about this. Okay. For us, our financial year will start on which date?
April.
And end on which date?
31st March.
Henceforth, remember, whenever I say what is the accounting year to be followed, you will not say January to December. You will say?
April to 31st March.
Now, my question was, how is it possible that you pay 5,000 of premium for the next year? When do you buy any vehicle? When do you buy any vehicle, appliances, assets, car, etc.? Yes, if you are able to afford, obviously. Suppose you are able to afford to buy a car in this year. But when would you buy that car? Neil, when would you buy that car?
So on special occasions because there is a sale.
Yes. Who answered this? Sahil.
Sahil, yes, sir.
And as Sahil answered, you generally buy the vehicles in Dashera, Dhanteras, Diwali, 31st December, when there is a good offer from the company. Is it or not?
Yes, sir.
Ganesh Chaturthi. Okay, there
is Christmas.
Yes, Christmas. There are specific occasions when the companies give you good offers. That if you buy the car in this period, 10 lakh of car will cost you 9,50,000. They will give you add-on features also. Insurance claim free for the first year. Insurance premium free for the first year. They'll give you added accessories free of cost. Do you find such benefits in specific occasions during the year and you prefer to buy at that time or not? Yes or no?
Yes.
Or will you buy your car every year on 1st April only? Are you a fool that you'll buy your car every year on 1st April only because our accounting year begins on 1st April? No, right? Now suppose, this is a very interesting question. You buy your car on 1st October. Now when you buy the car, you will pay insurance premium at that point of time. Is it or not?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
If you buy the car on 1st October, and you pay the insurance premium on that, what will be the validity of that premium? It will be valid till?
1 year,
sir. 31st September. So 30th September.
30th September of next year?
Yes, sir.
Means?
Yes, sir.
Means 1st October 2021, if you buy a car, it will be valid till 30th September 2022. Is it or not?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
But our year ends on? When does our accounting year ends?
31st March.
So can I say whatever premium you have paid, you have paid October, November, December, January, February, March, 6 months for this year. In our accounting year, 6 months will belong to this year. And then April, May, June, July, August, September. 6 months insurance premium you have paid for next year by default. Do you understand this? You buy the car on 1st October. So your insurance premium or policy will mature and will be valid till which date? Next year's 30th September. In between that, when does our accounting year end?
31st March.
So October, November, December, January, February, March, 6 months are in this year. And then again, 1st April next year will begin. So April, May, June, July, August, September, 30th September, 6 months will be of next year in that insurance policy. When does the year begin? Accounting year?
1st April.
When did you take the insurance policy?
1st October.
Insurance policy 1st October. When does your year end?
Our year? The 31st December.
31st March 21. And when when does the policy mature? Okay. Our year is from April to March and policy is from April to September. Do you understand this?
Yes, sir.
Now, can I say in the policy, this period belongs to current year and this period goes in the next year? Because your year ends on which day?
31st.
So, October to March is the current year and then here 1st April onwards next year will again start. So, this portion goes in the next year. Next year. So whatever premium you have paid, half of that premium's benefit you'll get in the current accounting year and half of that premium's benefit you'll get in the next accounting year.
Yes.
This is how it is possible that insurance premium will go for the next year. Okay. So in case if you buy the car on 1st January, once again, every one of you, when do you buy the car?
1st January.
Then can I say your policy will be from 1st January to 31st December?
Yes, sir.
Now in that, can I say January, February, March will belong to this accounting year?
Because
our accounting year will end on March. Accounting year will end in March, right? Then January, February, March, will 3 months belong to this accounting year or not?
Yes, sir.
And then April onwards, new year will begin?
Yes.
So April, May, June, July, August, September, October, November, December. 9 months will go in next accounting year. If you buy the car on 1st March, how many months are of this year? Only March is of this year. And April onwards, 11 months are of next year. If you buy the car in February, how many months are of this year?
Two.
Which 2 months?
February and March.
And 10 months are of?
Next year.
Are you all able to understand this now?
Yes, sir.
Every time you buy any policy, some months of that policy will belong to this year and some months of that policy will belong to next year. Yes, Diya, read the last sentence.
Mr. Prem withdraw ₹30,000 during the year for his personal use.
So let's start answering the questions, okay? Raise your hands. What is the amount of capital invested in the business by Prem? Shruti, you tell me.
Sir, the amount of capital investment is 15 lakh.
15 lakhs. Can you all see this, everyone?
No, sir. It is 15 lakh plus 5 lakh, 20 lakh.
Yes. Very good, Vyom. Shruti? Shruti?
Yes, sir.
Read this sentence, highlighted one.
Looking into the response, he decided to take in home appliances also further invested rupees 5 lakhs.
Initially, he invested 15 lakhs, then later on, again, he invested 5 lakhs. Did you understand this, Shruti?
Yes, sir.
So, what is the total amount he has invested? 15 plus 5, 20. That is his capital. Write down in your notebook. Case study 3. first question. Capital invested is equal to 15 lakhs plus 5 lakhs, 20 lakhs. Okay, next question. What is the amount invested by Mr. Prem in fixed assets? Raise your hand. Dvija?
Sir, Mr. Prem invested rupees 2 lakh on furnishing the shop and rupees 35,000 for purchase of computer and printer as fixed assets.
Yes. Can you all see these are the fixed assets? So what is the amount he has invested in fixed assets? 2 lakhs plus 35,000? 2,35,000. You all understand fixed assets, right? Those assets which remain in the business for long period of time. Furniture will remain in the business for long period of time. Computer will remain in the business for long period of time. So what is the amount he has invested in fixed assets? 2,35,000. So write down. So amount invested in fixed assets is equal to 2 lakh of furniture plus 35,000 of computer and printer . So what is the total amount invested in fixed assets? 2,35,000. Raise your hand. What is the amount of total purchases? Raise your hand. What is the amount of total purchases? Vyom, tell me total purchases.
Sir, 10 lakh towards purchase of electronic goods and 8 lakh of home appliances and electronic goods. End of. So total 18 lakh.
Yes. What is the amount of total purchases? Do you all get 18 lakhs, everyone?
Yes.
Yes.
So write down. Very good, Vyom. Total purchases is equal to 10 lakhs plus 8 lakhs. That is equal to 18 lakhs. I hope everyone is clear which 10 lakhs and 8 lakhs I am talking about. The one which is highlighted in green over here. Okay, I am reading it. What is the amount of long-term liabilities? Raise your hand. What is the amount of long-term liabilities? Long-term liability means amount payable by the business over a long period of time. Means after 1 year. Long period of time means that amount which the business has to pay back after 1 year. So tell me, what is the long term liability over here? Which amount you have to pay after 1 year?
There is no amount to be paid after 1 year.
Yes. There is no amount which we have to pay after 1 year. Nil. Have we borrowed any loan?
No.
No. At the most, our liabilities are these things which we have purchased on credit. And yes, our liability is the appliances which we have purchased on credit. Can you see this 2 lakhs purchased on credit?
Yes, sir.
But this is a short-term liability. This amount we have to pay within 1 year or not?
Yes, sir.
The goods which you purchase, you have to pay within 1 year only, right? So is there any amount which the business has to pay after 1 year?
No, sir.
There is no such amount. So long-term liability is nil. Write down. Long-term liability is nil. There is no long-term liability for the business as of now. Is everyone able to understand it? Next. What is the amount of current liabilities? What is current liability?
Sir, those... short period of time we have to pay the money.
Correct. The amount which the business has to pay within 1 year period of time. Raise your hand. What is the amount of current liabilities? Okay, Nemish. Tell me which are the current liabilities.
We want to get that 2 lakhs of credit.
Okay, 2 lakhs of credit. What else we have to pay within 1 year? Purple color, I am highlighting it. What else we have to pay within 1 year? Druhi?
10,000 of is yet to be paid to supplier of computer.
Yes, 10,000 we have to pay yet to the supplier of computer and printer. Yes, what else is our liability, everyone?
20,000.
Which 20,000? Yes?
Purchase is returned.
Purchase is returned.
Yes.
But this defective goods costing rupees? 20,000 were returned to the supplier, right? This goods costing rupees 20,000 were returned to the supplier. So can I say we have to pay to the supplier 20,000 rupees less? Will we pay 2 lakh rupees to the supplier now? Every one of you? See, we have to pay 2 lakh rupees to our supplier and we also returned him goods of 20,000. So can I say we will adjust this 20,000 with 2 lakhs of money?
Yes.
Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So instead of 2 lakhs, we will pay him only 1,80,000. So will our liability decrease by this 20,000 or not?
Yes, sir.
I buy goods of 50,000 from you. And if the goods are defective, I return back 10,000 of goods to you. Now, finally, I have to pay you 50,000 or 40,000?
40,000.
So, if I return back the goods to you, does my liability decrease because of that or not? 5,000 were yet to be paid. Can you all see this? So, what is our current liability? 1,95,000. Did you all understand it?
Yes, sir.
Write down. How come 1,95,000?
Sir, 2 lakhs plus 10,000 plus 5,000 minus 20,000.
Yes. What all I have highlighted in purple color? Very first of all, which is the amount highlighted in purple color?
10,000.
10,000. 10,000 we still have to pay for computers. Then 20,000 we have to minus, we'll do it at the end. 2 lakhs of goods are purchased on credit. And from this, we will minus 20,000 of goods which are returned. Able to understand this?
Yes, sir.
Okay, sir, can you explain this minus 20,000, how did this come? Once again.
Sahil?
Yes, sir.
We purchased goods from the supplier worth rupees 2 lakhs?
Yes, sir.
And in past, we also returned him goods of 20,000?
Yes, sir.
At that time, we had purchased goods costing 2,50,000 from the same supplier?
Yes, sir.
But that we had purchased in cash. Can you see here?
Yes, sir.
Now, if in future we again buy goods of 2 lakhs from him, we already returned him goods of 20,000, so we will pay him 1,80,000 only, na?
Yes, sir.
Because we already returned him goods of 20,000 in past. Okay? Sahil, yes, if I buy goods of 1 lakh from you,
yes, sir.
Okay? And I return back goods of 10,000 to you because they are defective. Okay?
Okay, sir.
How much do I have to pay you now?
90,000.
90,000. So if I am returning the goods of 20,000, will my liability decrease because of that or not?
Yes, sir.
Did you get this point now?
Yes, sir. Thank you.
Yeah. Okay, what else is in purple color, everyone? Salary payable is 5,000. So what is your current liability? Check it up. 2 lakh plus 10, 2 lakh 10,000 minus 20, 190 plus 5, 1 lakh 95,000 is your current liability. What is the next question asked? What is the amount of prepaid expense? What do you mean by prepaid expense?
Prepaid sir, payment means, in advance.
Yes, prepaid means paid in advance. You all can write that in bracket. What do you mean by prepaid, everyone?
Paid in
advance.
Advance.
Okay, which amount do you find over here is paid in advance?
Insurance.
Yes, insurance premium. Can you all see this 5,000 in red color? I have marked insurance premium paid in advance. Everyone? Next year means is it prepaid or paid in advance or not?
Yes.
Is that clear to everyone?
Yes, yes sir.
So prepaid expense is 5,000 of insurance premium paid for next year. Prepaid expense is 5,000 of insurance premium paid for next year. And that I explained you in detail. How is it possible that you pay the premium for next year? Next question. What is the amount of outstanding expenses? Now listen carefully. In accountancy, what do you mean by outstanding? Which is yet to be paid, payable. Which is yet to be paid or payable. In accountancy, outstanding doesn't mean standing out of the class because you get punishments. Or in accountancy, outstanding doesn't mean brilliant. Outstanding performance, brilliant performance. No. What do you mean by the word outstanding in accountancy? Yet to be paid. Write down over there, yet to be paid. What do you mean by the word outstanding? The money which is still payable. Are you all clear with this?
Yes, sir. But then what is the difference between outstanding and credit? Means credit is also yet to be paid. So
yeah, but here they are talking only about expenses, not goods.
Okay.
So which is the amount which is outstanding? Only this salary of 5,000? Sorry, this one. Salary is the 5,000. A salary of 5,000 is the only outstanding expense. Rest of all the amounts, 2 lakhs, 20,000 and 10,000 are either for computer or for goods. Can you see this?
Yes, sir.
So which is the outstanding expense? Salary of 5,000. 5,000 of salary is an outstanding expense. Okay, which is the next question? What is the income earned by Mr. Prem? How do you find the income, everyone? Is this formula studied or not?
Yes, sir.
What did we study about income term? Excess of revenue receipts over revenue expenses. Can you all see this?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
So how would you find your income? Revenue receipts minus revenue expenses. Okay. Now let us see what all are our revenue receipts. And then what all are our revenue expenses, one by one. I am marking the revenue receipts in which color? This blue color. Okay. So tell me which are the revenue receipts. All of you.
Sir, that.
So the 7 lakhs. Cost,
yes.
You sold goods costing 2,50,000 for 3 lakhs. So is that a revenue receipt or not? But from that goods of 25,000 were returned. That we will minus.
Yes, sir.
Okay. What else is revenue receipt for us? 3 lakhs. We have sold again goods. One customer purchased goods of 2,25,000 for 3 lakhs. 7 lakhs, 3,10,000, we will minus 25,000 because the goods are returned. Then one customer purchased from us goods of 2,25,000 for 3 lakhs, in which we give trade discount of
15,000.
That we will minus.
Sir, also 5,000 will also be minus. He was on the,
yeah, but that we will treat in revenue expenses separately. Okay. We will minus it, but we'll minus it in revenue expenses. Okay? Trade discount means, what did I tell you yesterday? We don't record it in the books of accounts. Do you remember?
Yes, sir.
We will directly take our sales as 3 lakhs minus 15,000, 2,85,000. Okay?
Next, yes, sir.
One customer purchased goods of 2,25,000 for 3 lakhs from us. Is this 3 lakhs also a revenue receipt or not?
Yes, sir.
And in that we have given trade discount of 15,000. So we will receive that much less amount?
Yes, sir.
So that also we minus. Did you understand all the revenue receipts now?
Yes, sir.
Anyone who did not understand this, raise your hand. All are clear with the revenue receipts?
Sir?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Sir, it says discount of 5,000 for payment within agreed time. So that will be all.
That we will subtract, Drui, but in revenue expense. We'll subtract it with revenue expense. Why did I minus this over here?
But that is a cash discount.
Yes, this 15 is trade discount, right?
Yes.
So this I have subtracted here because I won't record trade discount in my books of accounts. Means I will consider my sales as 2,85,000 only. Did you understand this?
Yes.
That cash discount also I will minus, but I'll minus it as a part of revenue expense. Okay? I'm coming to the revenue expenses now. Don't worry. Now we take revenue expenses. This goods which we sold for 7 lakhs, what was its cost? The goods which we sold for 7 lakhs, what was its cost?
5 lakhs.
5 lakhs.
Okay? So, this 7 lakhs of goods, the cost is 5 lakhs. Clear up till here, everyone?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Further, the goods which we sold on credit for 3,10,000, what was the cost of that?
2,50,000.
So that is also our revenue expense. Able to understand? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Now the goods which you returned of 25,000, what was the cost of those goods?
20,000.
So from this 5 lakhs and 2,50,000 also we returned goods of 20,000. Able to understand this?
Yes, sir.
Then this goods which you sold for 3 lakh rupees, what was its cost?
2,25,000.
2,25,000. And over here, you gave discount, further cash discount, how much?
5,000.
That is also our expense. Are you all able to understand this?
Yes,
sir. Sir, can you explain the minus 20,000 on revenue expenses?
Yes, we purchased goods of 7,50,000. Do you understand?
Yes, sir.
From that, we return goods of 20,000. Means actually our purchases are 7,30,000 only.
Yes, sir.
That's why we minus. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Which other expenses are involved? 2 LCD televisions of 50,000 means, can I say 1 lakh rupees?
Yes, sir.
They are destroyed and we received insurance claim of 30,000. So, can I say 70,000 is our loss?
Yes, sir.
Can I say 70,000 is our loss? Which loss? 2 TV into 50,000, 1 lakh minus 30,000 of insurance claim. So what is our loss over here? 70,000. Are you all able to understand this?
Yes, sir.
This loss of 70,000 is also our revenue expense. What else is our expense?
Insurance premium.
even salary is our expense. Salary, how much we have paid?
55,000.
And 5,000 is yet to be paid. So total expense is
60,000.
55,000 of salary plus 5,000 outstanding means what is the salary expense for the business? 60,000. Are you able to understand it, everyone?
Yes, sir.
And then insurance premium. What is the expense of insurance premium?
10,000.
But from 10,000, 5,000 belong to next year. So this year's expense is only 5,000. So what are our revenue expenses? First, revenue receipts. What all are our revenue receipts? 7 lakh plus 3 lakh 10. 10 lakh 10,000 minus 25,000. 9,85,000 plus 3 lakhs, 12,85,000 minus 15,000, 12,70,000. Is that clear to everyone?
Yes, sir.
Now 5 lakh plus 2,50,000, 750 minus 27,30. 7,30,000 plus 2,25,000, 9,55,000 plus 5, 9,60,000 plus 70, 10,30,000. Plus 60, 10,90,000, 11 minus 5, 10,95,000. So what is our income over here? 1,75,000. What is the profit earned by Prem? Same is the profit. This itself is profit. 1,75,000. Same amount is our profit. 1,75,000. Is it or not? All of you.
Yes, sir.
What is the amount due from debtors? What do you mean by debtors?
Customers.
To
whom we sell on?
Credit.
Customers to whom we sell on credit, right? So which are the customers you find to whom we have sold the goods on credit? This 3,10,000, have we sold on credit or not?
Yes, sir.
So that 3,10,000 is our customer first of all. And this, a customer purchased goods of 2,55,000, 25 for 3,00,000. Okay, that is credit not mentioned, right? No. So what is the goods sold on credit? What amount? Yes, what is the amount of goods sold on credit?
3,10,000.
And from that he returned goods of 25,000.
Minus 20,000.
Yes. All of you write down debtors is equal to 3,10,000 minus 25,000 of goods returned. So what is the amount of debtors over here? 2,85,000. What is the amount due to creditors? Creditors are the suppliers from whom we buy on credit. Okay.
Good.
So we have purchased 2,00,000 on credit. Can you all see this?
Yes, sir.
And from that 2,00,000 which we have purchased on credit, we have returned goods of 20,000 also in past. So the amount payable to creditors is 1,80,000. 2,00,000 of goods which we purchased on credit minus 20,000 we have returned also.
Sir?
Yes?
Sir, here how are you subtracting 20,000?
See, we have only one supplier from whom we are buying all the goods, right?
Yes, sir.
Creditors means the amount which is still payable to the suppliers for the goods purchased, okay? Now in past, because the goods were defective, you returned goods of what value to the supplier?
25,000.
No,
20,000.
25,000, our customers returned to us.
Yes.
We returned back for 20,000, is it or not?
Yes.
Did the supplier pay you back in cash at that time?
No.
sir.
So in future, if you buy goods of 2 lakhs from the same supplier, will you adjust that 20,000 of return goods amount or not?
Okay.
Yes, 10th question, everyone. What is the 10th question? Closing stock. How do you find the amount of closing stock be attended? Very first, what is the value of goods we purchased in the beginning?
10 lakhs.
10 lakhs of electronic items were purchased. Did you all understand it? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Sir.
Okay. After 10 lakhs, you sold goods costing rupees 5 lakhs. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
From 10 lakhs, you sold goods costing 5 lakhs. So will I minus it or not? We purchased goods of 10 lakhs. From that, we are selling goods worth rupees?
5 lakhs.
5 lakhs. So that goods go out from our business. Further, we sold goods costing 2,50,000 also. You sell goods of 2,50,000, so they go out. Is it or not?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
And then the customer also returns you goods whose cost is 20,000. So do 20,000 of goods again come back in the business or not?
Yes, sir.
Either yes, you can sir. Directly minus 2,30,000. Or you can minus 2,50,000 which are going out and then returned ones also come back. Is this clear?
Yes, sir.
Same goods we also return back to the supplier again. First, the customer returns to us. Then we also return it back to the supplier. Is it or not?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Then, he further purchased home appliances of what amount?
8 lakhs.
8 lakhs. From that, in the next paragraph, again he sold goods costing what amount?
2,25,000.
So count what is the closing stock. Even this televisions of 1 lakh have got destroyed or not?
Yes.
1 lakh of TVs destroyed. So that also doesn't remain with us. So what is the closing stock remaining with us?
7,25,000.
7,25,000. Yeah. Okay. So next question 11.
Value of
purchases.
Net purchases. Net purchases means we purchase goods of rupees 5 lakhs. No, 10 lakhs. First, we purchase goods worth rupees
10 lakhs.
Then we purchase goods of 8 lakhs again, 18 lakhs. And we have returned goods of 20,000. So, 17,80,000. What are the net purchases? Net means after deducting purchase returns. First, you purchase goods of 10 lakhs. Then you purchase goods of 8 lakhs. And then you return goods of 20,000. So what are your net purchases? 17,80,000. Is that clear?
Yes, yes, sir.
Then
yes, sir.
What is the trade discount allowed? We already discussed. What is the trade discount? 15,000. Do you all get it? Do we directly have trade discount available 15,000 or not?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Okay, then 13th question. What is the cash discount? 5,000?
5,000.
We discussed that. Okay. So you like, has Prem allowed cash discount? Yes. Cash discount is 5,000. Then after cash discount, what is the next one? Drawings. At the last sentence, do you find 30,000 for personal use? Okay. So what is the drawings amount?
30,000.
15th question. Sales return. After selling the goods, customer return goods of 25,000. Is it or not?
Yes, sir.
So sales return is 25,000. And the last question is purchase return. So purchase return, we return goods of 20,000 to the supplier. We return goods of 20,000 to the supplier. Is it or not?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So that is purchase return. So quite a comprehensive question. I want all of you to repeat it in the homework. I want every one of you to repeat this in the homework. Okay. That'll be all for this day. Bye, everyone.
Bye, sir.
Bye.